So I've never done this before. I don't know if you can hear me. Hello. I get my comments on here. Hey everybody, somebody let me know if you can hear me. I've never done this before. Hayden Emmons, hey. Okay, you can hear me, cool. Matthew, awesome, good to see you guys. Or not see you, but see your names on the screen, because I can't see you. So I want a few more people to get here, and I'll start walking around everywhere. The Netherlands, man, that's awesome. I have a friend from the Netherlands. He has a name that I cannot pronounce. It's kind of funny. Hello from Ireland, man. Dub Echo. You guys are all over the place. That's amazing. So this is weird for me, just so you know, from the UK, awesome, Tennessee. Hey, I know where that is. Yeah, I've definitely not done anything live before, so you guys get to experience this with me. 21 of you there. John Baker, hey, what's up? Petrina, Virginia, hey, I know where that is. So I'm doing this on my phone. I'm gonna try real hard not to make you guys sick walking around. Odin, hey, Carol from Canada, awesome. So we got some snow. It's a bit of a storm, and apparently there's a huge system coming in today, later, but right now it's blue skies. So, hey, Becky, good to see your name. Susan Hester, hey. Yep, Indiana, Idaho, that's awesome. Hey, Paul. Pam, what's up? Good to see your face. Yeah, I actually shaved a little bit so you can see my face. Yes, Moria, the neighbors are thrilled. You can see the front of this house. I'll just show you the rest of the neighborhood. Sweden. Awesome, you guys are all over the place. So I'll try not to show any traffic. We'll be going inside in just a minute. They're looking at me like, what are you doing? It's funny. Paul, thanks, praying for Pop. So yeah, the rest of the houses in the neighborhood are considerably smaller, a little bit more spread apart. Then you have this big monster. So, Matthew, I'm going to be doing a compilation from everything on the inside of the house. Yes. The white stuff, I don't know. It appeared. All the white stuff on the ground. We're supposed to get like up to 6 inches tonight. They've already canceled church for tomorrow. I was pretty bummed out. I love playing at church. So, well, I'll get walking around a little bit here. You guys have seen the outside of the house quite a bit. Phoenix, Arizona, awesome. Let's see if I can keep from slipping and falling for the entire internet to see. Thanks, Judy. I really try to make it entertaining and fun and all that stuff. So the outside of the house, Yeah, Molly's inside her, and we'll see her in just a minute. It's too cold for her out here. So, I like this little area. It's pretty secluded from the road, which, yeah, it's gonna be like, if I lived here, I'd probably just have a bunch of cars and junk and whatever else in this whole area right here. Then I still got to get rid of that, haul it off. That's the old condenser unit for the AC. There's the backyard. So yeah, thanks. There's a pretty big difference compared to how it used to look. Rottingham, the Netherlands, man. That is really cool. Okay, so you guys ready to go inside? Before I do that, a quick funny story about the front thing that I made for the door. I don't think I've ever told you guys this. I've had a couple of people comment on, oh, look, I even put in the little details about these two. Becky, it's going on the market this week, and I'll get into all that later. So I had comments about these two little details that I put in, and they match. Well, the funny thing is I built this all out of scrap wood I had in my barn. Portugal, sustainable farmer. That's awesome. So there was a hole right here, and on this side, there was a hole right there on the bottom one. So I just matched them. That way I cover the hole and it makes it look like I meant to do that, but no, it was just to cover a hole. So. Okay, you guys ready? I'm gonna kick my shoes off so my wife doesn't kill me. All right, so here is the entrance. Get the light on. Yay. Really happy with the ceiling. And then the stairwell. Hey, Ethan. My mother-in-law, Molly's mom, actually did a lot on the stairs, on cleaning off all of the individual balusters. She did all of the work on the top here. So very, very grateful for the help from her. She's really happy with the ceiling, how all of the tiles turned out up there. And this goes straight back. So there was a bathroom right in the middle here. You guys have seen that in the videos in the past. And if you haven't, go check them out, because it was a really weird place for a from France. Hey, Helen. There was a, yeah, the bathroom right here. I'm really ADD, so it's going to be hard for me to keep track of the comments and remember what I'm talking about. And there was a bunch of damage in the side here and then up in the top. So I had to refabricate all these pieces, but I think the entryway is pretty cool. Pretty nice. And then let's go to, this is the first bedroom. Thanks, Francis. Yeah, it was a nasty bathroom. It was disgusting. Biohazard all the way. So carpet in this room, closets. You saw in one of the videos I was talking about putting those things up at an angle sideways. It just didn't look right. And it actually didn't completely cover the hole. Thanks, Kaylin. Appreciate it. Jennifer, thank you. So we just put it square. And it's okay. I think it still worked out. And I did get these coated, so you might be able to see a little bit of a sheen. That way, nothing falls off. You can brush up against it. So we'll go this way. Well, actually, you wanna go upstairs first? Yeah, okay. Well, you left the brick and kept the history. Yeah, I tried to keep as much of the history as I possibly could. That's important to me. For whatever reason. If there's no real reason to remove it, just leave it. Hey, so blessed from Tennessee. Thanks. Okay, so here's the landing up to the bedrooms upstairs, and then carpet in both of those rooms. Walk backwards awkwardly. There's a light. Yep. So this is the bedroom, and I think it was the first or second video I put up where we're chucking stuff out the window down to the bottom. So the camera would have been right about here, and I was hurling stuff out that window because this room was full all the way up with stuff. Really nasty. All kinds of weird stuff we found. So I am going to be getting to our future plans and the price for the house and all that kind of stuff here in a little bit. Just wanted to walk you guys around first. So here's the other bedroom. Call this the cat poo bedroom. I did a video where I was standing like this talking about the foot and a half deep pile of cat poo that I found in the middle, which had to be cleaned up thoroughly. So these are the bedrooms upstairs. I can go back down. Were there any sellable gems amongst the junk? Yes. So the way that worked, it actually worked out pretty well. I had a buddy who's an antique dealer, and he paid me a set amount, and he could have anything in the house that he wanted. He's in actually, I think the first video or the second video of us cleaning the house out. And his name is Toby. Good dude, real fun. So I just paid him, or he paid me a certain amount. Cat poo room out of the description. Will not be putting that in the description, Becky. Yes, I know. But you guys knew what it was, so there you go. So he could keep anything he wanted, and thanks, Russell. And he, where was I? Sorry, I get distracted. So yeah, the salvageable, sellable stuff. I let him have anything in the house that he wanted, except for coins, which my son Bruce really loves to collect, and any cash money. I kept all that. Hey, Brenda. So he kept everything else, and there was quite a bit. He took, I don't know how many truckloads. Hey, you know her. The most beautiful woman on earth has arrived. Actually, she's been here, but anyway. So she's shy, believe it or not. Thumbs up, thanks, Laurie. So this is a living room. I think the floors turned out really good for what they were. There was obviously a little bit of staining in a few spots, and Maria says hi. I think she's still hiding.
What?
Becky says hello, most beautiful woman on earth.
Hello to Becky.
So we'll go in the living room in just a second. Thanks, Russell. Yeah, a lot of that was Molly doing the poly. Well, we both did the first coat, and then she hand sanded the first coat and then did the second coat on her own. And I spent like 20 hours on my hands and knees sanding and all kinds of fun stuff. But I think they turned out really good for what they are. So, okay, we'll walk down this way. So, from the front door, you got straight back to this little area, and from right here, from this wall, back that way. Shauna says hi.
Hi, Sean.
Molly says hi, Shauna. This was all a porch. It went all the way back, so I just chopped everything up and put individual rooms in. So there's your light. Then this is the exterior door to the outside, out into that area. Down the stairs. Are we going to do an open house? I think the realtor is probably going to do an open house, yes. So, this was a nice little addition. So, you come in the door right there, and then you've immediately got somewhere to put stuff like that. And then we put in some outlets for plugs or whatever. This is the original ceiling that was in the porch. We just coated it well, and Again, I like original stuff. Door has a nice closing thump. Yes, I like a good tight door. A well-tuned door and a well-tuned toilet both make me happy. So, yeah, I'm weird. Okay, here's the bathroom. There's that fantastic tub. I spent many, many hours getting that thing sanded, cleaned, prepped, and then Molly and her mom both finished it. Left side Ian's there who said to put it on the left. That's how we did it. So you guys win. There's no prize, but you guys win. So that way you can sit on the toilet and wash a baby or puke, you know, whatever. So Molly's laughing at me. So there's the sink and the window. It's all finished up. The floors in here are all the locked together vinyl laminate stuff. Luxury vinyl, they call it. I really like it. It's really tough stuff. So. Engineered vinyl plank. Because she's smarter than I am. She knows words like that. Okay. Here's the main area. Yes, I still have this because I'm tall and I whack my head on things. So here's the kitchen area. There you go. I can see the whole kitchen area. Where are you located? we're in Virginia, but I'm already booked up. Sorry. No, I don't know. Anyway, yeah, the floor in here. This is probably the nicest of the three that we did. I really like it. Hey, 99% canning Butch Eeks. Okay. That's an interesting name. And then we had to split it down the middle. I had all that in one of the videos. And then the kitchen. LOL. Okay. I'm glad you have a sense of humor. That's good. So spot for the fridge and spot for the gas stove, which I have prepped on the side, the gas inlet. That way whoever buys a place can just put in their own stuff that they want. So anything you want to say about the kitchen? Still being shy. Then here is the laundry room, right off the kitchen. Thanks, Erica. And this is one of the original doors with the glass in it. I like it so that when you're in the kitchen, you can get some of that natural light in. Even though that's the north side of the house, still, you know, it just keeps everything open. And there's plenty of room in here if the new owners want to put in shelving or whatever. I'll go from this side. So it's lots of room. And again, we left the original ceiling in place in this, because again, this was a porch all the way down. And the floor in one of the videos, you'll see I had to raise that section of floor up. I think it was like 10 1/4 inches. And I was so happy that I got it just completely smooth across. It's probably a 1/16 of an inch variant in it. So, yeah, I saw a comment about the shelves. I think they turned out really good. So I custom cut these and put them in, and then Molly's mom sanded them, stained them, and polyurethane them. So much appreciated to her. There's the tile. So if there's anything specific you guys want to see, just let me know. I'd be happy to show you. Then, of course, everything is working. Got a nice pull out in there. And one cool thing is I put the AC vent and the heater vent right there. So when you're standing here, dishes, keep your feet warm. Molly would like that, right?
Yep.
Okay, so then we're going to go back into the master's. I think we're allowed to say that anymore. We're going back into the primary suite. I think that's the word they're supposed to use now because reasons. Floor in here turned out pretty good. A couple of big stains, but it's okay. And then that was the original door. That was the door that I put in. I busted that through. That way, thanks, Itachi. So we just got a little closet and I put some of the vinyl plank down the bottom. And then the best part of the house, the big master, no, can't say that anymore. Primary suite, goes back in here with a giant walk-in closet. And on this side is the other. No, there's no bathrooms upstairs. I thought about it and tried. There was no way to do it. I would have ended up losing so much room in the bedrooms that it just wasn't worth it. So there's the big stand-up shower. Forget being politically correct. Yeah, but there's 235 of you on there. I might offend somebody. So big stand-up shower, shelving, open shelving, and then the other necessities. Say hi to yourself. Hi. Okay. And these shelves are easily removable. They just pop right in. And then this whole panel comes off so you can access all the stuff for the shower. Because having been in repairs for so long, I like having things accessible. So that's the basics of the house. Where is the other bathroom? So that was the master, and then you go down this way, and there's the first one. So there you go. JW, yeah, I'm gonna be leaving a bunch of information about the house. I don't know if I'll do pictures or not, I don't know. So, because you guys are probably gonna wonder, it's going on the market this week. I think they're gonna be doing an open house. I don't anticipate it staying long on the market. And what's the price? Should we say that? I don't know.
It would be public.
Yeah, it's public anyway. We're going to list it for $249.9 and see what happens. So I know you're going to have a lot of questions about the profit. Probably not going to get into that. There's some personal reasons. But yes, we are going to make some money on it, obviously. But yeah, all of the different locations around the country and around the world all have completely different real estate prices. And you know, this house in, you know, a fancier neighborhood in the same area, you know, probably even, I gotta switch arms, probably even half hour away would go for an additional $100,000. But because of where it is, that's the price it's going to have to be at for the, thanks Fiona, for the house. So Paul, yes, we're going to make our money back and make enough for the future thing. Would we do another house like this? I don't know. You know, that's just, it's up to God. We just have to follow his lead. We're going to be doing an addition on our house, to give ourselves some more room. That's going to be the next video, video series, I guess you could call, is that addition that I'm putting in. I am going to build myself a shop studio, and then past that, I don't know. I have a business that I'm going to be ramping up, getting going better, and there's a few other things that we're thinking about, but don't know. The future is it's in God's hands. I don't know. That will sell for $790 in the Netherlands. Can you ship it? Yeah, I'll have it in the mail tomorrow, buddy. No problem. You pay for shipping costs. How about that?
Oh, the Netherlands.
Yeah, I like the Netherlands. Just tuned in. Gonna watch from the beginning. Okay, yeah. Eva, yeah, watch from the beginning. You have to do something for your channel. Another channel. Yeah, it'll all be on the channel. I'm gonna be uploading videos, hopefully getting some fun stuff in there. Francine, I don't know if I ever would want to do any major network stuff, like all of the HGTV. I have to be careful what I say about that. I don't want to seem mean, but I don't think I would ever do any kind of, any of that kind of stuff. Russia, heck yeah, Victor, awesome. Yeah, we hope it sells fast. There was a comment a little while back about an island. We had thought about putting in an island. We thought about doing a lot of stuff, but honestly, I think right now.
Yeah, if we were gonna move into the house, that we would. I even had an island that I picked out that I would have put in, but we'll let people, depending on how they like to cook and how they like to entertain and everything, they can pick their own, and we don't have to worry about their personal preferences. And
yeah, because I think what we're trying to do is just provide a blank slate, you know, like you always got to think about the ROI. Like what I talk about all the time is return on investment. There's so much stuff we could have done, and if we were living here, we would have done. I finally look relaxed. Oh, thanks. So let's see, since you carry the house for so long, capital gains taxes shouldn't hurt you. Yeah, I don't know.
Actually, capital gains is skipped if you lived in the house, and we didn't end
right.
up living here.
Yeah, we've never lived here, so we're going to have to pay capital gains. There's no way around that, but
this is the first house he's fixed up that I didn't get to live in.
Yeah, that's right. All the other ones that I've done, or that we've done together, what, four or five now, we've lived in as we're doing everything. So show the basement. Yes, I wanted to go down here.
Yeah, that's what I was going to bring up. He hadn't shown off his duct work. He got to learn how to do some duct work with the HVAC guy.
Yeah. So, yeah, we are in the bottom left southwestern area.
Appalachia.
Even though it's actually Appalachian. When I moved to this area, everybody kept saying Appalachia. I was like, you broke your what? It sounds goofy saying Appalachia, but I'm not originally from this area. So let me get my shoes on. Be a little awkward for a second. I'm glad I got my slip-on shoes. All right, where's the idea? Where was there ideas or hints that your dad provided help? Okay, John, I'm a third generation builder. I grew up building houses with my dad and pop, my granddad. So I worked with my dad until I moved out, you know, when I was, thank you, love the banisters. When I was 18, I think I moved out. Anyway, and then I have worked for several different contractors and learned a bunch on my own. So at this point, believe it or not, I was actually showing my dad stuff, which was a really weird paradigm shift because I was always, you know, the underling. I was always the one learning from him. Now, all of a sudden, I'm the one showing him all of the new ways of doing stuff and the faster ways, because I've been doing it for 20 years now on my own.
And codes have changed since your dad was.
Yeah. And a lot of the codes have changed. A lot of the tools have changed. The techniques have changed. So, you know, he'd get his stuff together and start a job, like the outlets, for example, being the other way. He was blown away when I told him, no, they've got to be the wrong way. Thank you. Appreciate that.
Just the keys.
Yeah, I got my keys. Okay, let's go downstairs.
Get in basement.
Yep. Okay. I'll take all 275 of you down there. Molly is beautiful. Yes, she is. She is an amazing human being. Beautiful inside and out. I definitely, definitely married up. I don't know why God gave me her, but, you know. Ducks in the basement, yes. I left the door open and had some food down there for him. All right. Let's see if I can get down this hill. Okay. It's a little slick, so I'm being careful. All right, here's the basement. Here's the light. Okay, so we just got the duct work completed, so that I still have some stuff to take out, so you'll have to bear with me for a second. So here is the whole mechanical room. How old is this house? The original part was built in 1890, and then it had an addition in the 30s, and then an addition in the 70s, and then I found it. So here's your manifold, plumbing manifold, and then all the ducting. Got the furnace working real good, and then there's the ducting as it goes down into the house. Nothing super fancy, but it works. Just a little tight mechanical room. Did you have to raise the roof in the basement? No. So all of this is new all the way across. You'll probably remember in one of the other videos, I busted all this out, and there was a staircase right here, and The entire staircase, no joke, literally no joke, was being held on by that nail. I left it there just because. I usually take out all the nails, but I wanted to leave that one because that was the only nail holding the staircase up. So, wow, I cannot believe it hadn't fallen already. And it just busted through the top of the wood when I took the stairs down, so it wasn't even held up. And then in this section back there is the old floor, and then I built on top of the old floor and tied it in correctly with the outside wall. So, and then the rest of the basement, go through there. A separate connector per water connection is really, yes, it is. It is a fantastic idea, and I went over why in one of the other videos. So this is all open. When I got the house, I'm gonna set you right here for a second. When I got the house, I came in the door. The door only opened about that much because of stuff. And then when I pushed my way in, there was a wall of just junk right about where the flue is. And I couldn't really get past it. I didn't know what was back there. All of the windows were all completely painted. So there was zero light. Even the flashlight was just getting absorbed into all of the junk. It was crazy. And I loved it because I ain't scared of anything. I was like, yeah, let's go dive in and see what kind of, you know, critters are in there or whatever. So I honestly didn't even know how far back the basement went. I couldn't get to it. So this was, I think, the last place in the house that we cleaned out. We started at the top and came down. And when I got to the back wall, I was like, man, that's a pretty good sized basement. That's cool. So, but yeah, there's the rest of the ducting for the bedrooms and all that stuff. So, well, that's that. Anything else you guys want to see in the basement? Any questions about it? Be happy to tell you. When did I start the project? About 3 years ago. And I've just been doing it on the side in addition to my normal job. That's incredible. Thank you, Obi-Wan. Was there any salvageable? There was. And I had explained earlier that I had a guy that came in and got all of it. Well, thank you, Francine. There's a couple of us still out there that aren't just money hungry. Where's my clone? Oh, I had to lock him in the closet. He kept kicking me. What a jerk. And then the backyard, nice building back there. That's my lawnmower that I had been mowing everything with. And of course, I left it too long and the battery died. So there it sits. I have to get it moved out today or tomorrow. So I'll go back in the side, back in with Molly. I was pretty happy with the little stoop that we built so that you can stand here out of the rain. Got about 2 feet. So yeah, please let me know if you guys have any questions. I'll hang out for a little bit longer with you, all 300 of you. If there's any questions you have or comments, be happy to answer them. I'm going to set you down so I'm not making you sick. Here we go. Cool. Anything else you want to talk about? Okay. Basement is so clean and bright. Yeah, I had to put all those lights in. There wasn't anything down there. Centennial, South Virginia. By this house, yeah. How old is the house? 1890s, and then an addition in the 20s or 30s, and then 70s in the back.
Have you ever shown the black and white photographs that we found?
I don't think so. I have a couple of old black and white photos that were taken from, that were taken from across a valley into this area. What part turned out the best? The fact that it's gonna sell. I mean, I don't have a favorite. I don't really do favorites about anything. But the neighbors are happy. Yes, they are. It will be on Zillow. Yeah, it's gonna go out to, it's a full blitz. So we're using a realtor company. Thank you, Dave. I was pretty happy not painting the brick. It was a good idea. Let's see.
Over for.
Well, Tim, you could have come over anyway. I'd have, you know. Make you do something. Hey, from the Netherlands. There's a bunch of you guys from the Netherlands. That's awesome. I would love to come visit.
Great grandfather's from the Netherlands.
Oh yeah, I have blood from the Netherlands.
Olie
Schlager. Yeah, I don't know if anybody there knows Olie Schlager. I'm probably saying it wrong. Yes, there is an attic, and both of the ports are about that big. You know, I'm fairly small, and I have a hard time getting in. But it's they're all sealed up, and you can get into them again. But am I gonna start another house? I talked about that earlier. We don't know. Just have to see what happens. Looking forward to my next projects. Hopefully, my next projects are gonna be
sunroom.
Yeah, building my wife's sunroom on her house. Hi from Oklahoma, and then
big metal.
Yeah, building myself a studio so that I can do what I'm supposed to be doing, which is making giant artwork. Olie Schlager has written all the car maintenance books in the Netherlands. Ha! Cool!
Yes.
I'm famous in the Netherlands. I didn't even know it. Sweet. No, my great-grandfather was a wood carver. He did all really cool carving stuff, so I got art in me veins. Amazing and blessed. Thank you, Jeannie and Linda. So the great big building, we're gonna do probably, I don't know, 40 by 60 or something like that. And I'm gonna be able to make giant pieces of art, which is, Shauna says wahoo.
Wahoo.
Yeah, which is what I really wanna be doing with my life. You can see in a couple of my past, you know, hey, she from Texas. A bunch of my past videos a while back, you can see some of the other bigger pieces of art that I've made, sculptures and moving kinetic things, and that's really what I want to do with the rest of my life. This is just to, a means to an end, you know? Yeah, the music and everything. My son does almost all the music now. He is incredibly gifted and loves doing it, so I always enjoy it. We're in the Appalachia Mountains down southwest area. Hello from Kazakhstan. Cool.
Ooh, Adil!
Yeah, I had a buddy named Adil from Kazakhstan. He was a really cool guy. I was a camp counselor. Molly and I were 20 years ago, and there's a guy named Adil from Kazakhstan. It's pretty cool.
He was appalled by American boys.
Why don't you come over here and talk?
Oh.
He can't stop. There you go. He was what?
He was appalled by American boys' lack of, I don't know, their potty humor just.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Totally cultural difference.
Poor guy.
Yeah. Like if somebody passed gas or something, which in America, who cares? You know, he was
very offended.
It was incredibly offensive. So
it's gross.
Yeah. So this is fun. So we'll hang out for another couple minutes. If you guys have any more questions, never censor my words. I look for the country. Yeah, free speech. That's absolutely right. Yeah, most of the time I don't care, but I don't know. I have to be careful because I don't really have a filter. Biggest setbacks in the project. Oh man, there was a bunch. Weather has been a huge setback. And then just making sure that I stayed working, because I was working out of town doing electrical in other states all over the country for weeks at a time. So it would just take a long time sometimes. I'd end up with 3 or 4 weeks between actually gracing the doorway. The bricks that I took home, we're thinking like pizza oven would be kind of cool, or using them somewhere. Shauna from Ireland, hey, I can't read that. I don't read Russian. Yeah, Sherry, please check out the rest of the video. It's good to actually see your name. You've been a subscriber for a long time, which is cool. Great project, best from the Netherlands. Another one. So yeah, the bricks, I don't know. They're really, really, really old and falling apart and crumbling. I don't know that they would be good to actually use for a whole lot of anything. Thank you for saying my name correct, Gregory. I appreciate that. Live in the UK, movers, you're doing a splendid job. Thank you. Torash, I think. It disappeared. The comments only stay up for a second and they disappeared. So, but yeah, the future is bright for us, I think. Being able to take the profit that we get from here and be able to use it, invest it into our own house. She loves plants, loves playing in the dirt. So I'm gonna build her a big sunroom on the side of the house. Tall ceilings, cathedral, full wall of windows. And so she'll be able to grow stuff and play in the dirt. I'm trying to squat down so I can be on the same level. Cause she's short and I'm not.
I am short.
Yeah.
I'm kind of curious to know from the people who have been watching Barry most of the time, what the most interesting thing was that he did, or what you guys think was interesting that he did.
You're right, Pamela. Thank you, Barbara. Good luck on selling. Yeah, it's going to sell fast. I mean, there was a house just down the road here that was on the market for, what, 2 hours?
Something like it was that. Under contract like a day after it showed up on the internet.
Yeah, okay, so the next day it was under contract. Removing the basement stairs. Was that a question? That was all I got.
It was the most interesting.
Special effects. Thanks, Becky. So, those of you who don't know, I do have a background in filmmaking, so I like in putting that into my videos because boring talking head videos are boring to me. I don't want to force somebody else to do something that I think is boring. Water manifold, cool. Sense of humor. What sense of humor? I don't understand. The whole process, yeah.
Okay.
Method special effects, yeah. I think modifications is the thing. Show real craftsmanship. Thank you. I always try to do everything as unto the Lord, so. You guys are talking too fast. I wonder if I can go back. Hey, yeah, there we go. What now? Janie, you'll just have to check out the video. I've talked about it a couple times already. The doubles, beautiful victory. Yeah, I love doing the cloning stuff. It's funny. Craftsmanship. Q&A video. Okay, good. Yeah, Deborah, I haven't had anybody talk about that. Need a special hallway and moldings. Yeah, thanks. It's also, part of that is just necessity because it's so expensive to buy all of that fancy trim. It's ridiculously expensive. And again, I gotta watch the ROI. I can't spend too much. So, making most of it was a lot better. And I have the tools for it. So, just take the time and do it. Make it, don't buy it. Process. Awesome. Thank you, Gene, Linda. I try to keep the quality good. That's something that's floor plan sketch, please. Okay, that's easy. So just write down what you see. And okay. I love it, of course. Yeah, I worked with my dad for my whole life up until I moved out, and then a little bit after. I think we had already gotten married, and I went up there to help him build something. Didn't I? I don't remember. Too long ago. Way I reused or repurposed. Yeah, that's important to me. Dollhouses, cool.
Dollhouses.
Pamela, I'd love to see some of them if you have a website or anything. Finishing from Maine, cool. Germany, cool. I was born in Germany. Love watching things as well. Nice. So, yeah, this has been cool. I'd like to try to do live a little bit more often. I've never tried it before. So It's gonna be interesting seeing what other comments I get. Came out from UK builders, no sponge. Yes, proud of the accomplishments. Problem solving on the stairs, cool. Donna is gonna be listed for money. Hopefully we'll get money for it. I was born on a military base in Germany. So I had, I have two birth certificates, it's kind of cool. We're listing it for $249,900. So if you can't make it yourself, do it and then teach quality. Yes, good. Ontario, Canada, Helen, cool. I was gonna say something, I forgot. What it was.
I can't tell you what you were gonna say.
Yeah. Okay, Jack, yes, I'm gonna do a full interior time lapse like I did on the outside of the house. That's my most watched video ever. So yeah, thank you. Hopefully we will make our money. It's, you know, goes on the market this week. So hopefully everything won't crash before then. Thank you for your channel. Well, thank you for following. It's been an adventure. It's kind of funny because I started YouTube a long time before my parents did. And a lot of you know that my parents have their channel, Live Simple, Live Free. And I mentioned to my dad one time that, is your wife the realtor? No, we're not using Molly. We're going with a bigger organization.
My license isn't active right now anyway, yeah. So it...
Yeah, so you have to reactivate. So anyway, and then I was telling my dad about it and he was like, you can make money with YouTube? Because he was just looking for some extra cash. I was like, yeah. And then his has exploded. He has like a bajillion subs now. And here's my little 15,000. But you know what? It's cool because I like every one of you. Love your parents' channel. Thank you. Yeah, they're... I'm trying to teach him the ways of the filmmaking. No. Yeah, he does a good job. Definitely a different style, but that's cool. Everybody has their own thing. Praying for Pops, thanks. Yeah. So, okay, well, maybe another couple minutes here and nice work in GarageBand. Yep. Yeah, we do most everything we do in GarageBand. We're musicians on real instruments, but I don't have a good way of recording that. Enter the house and realize how much stuff it took me a lifetime. Yeah. It was a lot of stuff, like three, I think, 40-yard containers. But anyway, once we get some more space in the house, I'm hoping, or once I get my studio, I'm hoping to actually set up a actual live recording studio. Because I'm a musician and my kids play piano, my kids sing.
And your parents.
And of course, my parents play everything. So I've been helping them do a lot of the recording for their bigger music videos and stuff, and then they'll record it. Francine, no, I've never talked to the previous owner. I know their names, but no, I've never talked to them. I don't know that I'd want to. Just, you know, things change and things move on. Love the stairway, thank you. Original price paid. Yeah, again, I don't want to get too much into the previous monies. It wasn't a lot. So getting to know me, thank you. I let you guys know some stuff about me. I'm pretty complicated. All right. Let's see your metal art pieces. Thank you, Patricia. Flit sells fast. Job on the front door. Kaylin, I have not had time to look. I still have that piece of wallpaper, but it, I just haven't had time to put the money into it.
Welcome, Dean and Linda.
Yeah, how long did you have your parents' house before they got it? About a year. I had renters in it for about a year. How many homes have I flipped? I think this is my, well, flipped or built, like buy an old house and flip it. I think this is the fifth.
I don't don't really like the term flipped because it sounds so fast. It sounds like a pancake, like instant, and we take years to do anything.
Yeah. So I think five. Hey, from London. Zeno. So yeah, I think I've flipped five and I've built from scratch just since I moved out of my parents' house on my own with us two, because we got married really quickly after I moved out. Three from scratch, and two of them were at the same time. So yeah, I don't recommend it to anybody. That's one of the things, like my soapboxes, of which I have many, is I've had a lot of people that, friends that I have in this area, that see what I do and they're like, I can do that, and then they end up burning bad. Take a vacation. Don't tell me what to do. So you have to have the experience. If what I recommend to anybody that wants to do this kind of stuff is get hired by a contractor and spend about 10 years learning everything you can. Then branch out. You know, it's like somebody who just doesn't have a whole lot of experience trying to do something that is very technical or has a specific knowledge base. You know, I certainly wouldn't want to like try to do surgery on somebody, you know, without having the experience. So it's the same thing with houses, because you can lose so much money. We have lost a lot of money. Those two that we built side by side from scratch, I mean, it was just raw land when we got it, happened right in 2008. So they were done and then everything crashed. So it's risky. It's very, very risky. So be very careful if you ever want to try flipping houses, because it's not like it is on the TV. It's just, it is not the same thing. That stuff is so fake. Do I have a new project? Yes, stay tuned. Very good advice. Thank you. Let's see. Yeah, that one, the one big house that we built, the other one that we built from scratch, I was working full time. I was on a 60-hour week that week at my regular job, and then doing that. And I came back one time after work to find that the contractor that was digging the basement that I had hired hit rock. And without notifying me or stopping, he just bulldozed forward at like $300 an hour. So just the foundation was like $40,000. Wasn't expecting that, you know, and that took a huge chunk. So stuff like that, you know, just what is my regular job? This, I'm a contractor, do other work, pretty much anything that's legal to make money. So. And I'm going to be building up a separate business, in addition to that, which I may talk to you guys about later. Love that we saved the old bathtub. Yes, I am too. 1923 square footage. How big is this? 3,000 something?
Most of the rooms are a little over 13 feet square, but I don't have in my head how big it is.
Yeah, I think it's a little over 3,000 something. I don't know. No? 2,000? I don't know. I just make stuff up.
Can't math that fast.
No, I don't math in my head. Why didn't he inform you? That's just the way it is. You know, I didn't have.
We were in our very early 20s, and it was our first build, and education costs. Mm-hmm.
I wasn't as big and scary looking as I am now, and I didn't have the intestinal fortitude to tell him to go jump in a creek somewhere, because he did something I didn't tell him to. So.
Yeah.
I just paid him. How did you get the purple primer off the bathtub? We didn't have any purple primer on the bathtub. But purple primer, if you're talking about plumbing, PVC purple primer, it's very alliterative, is an acid. Good luck. That is just about impossible to get off of anything.
It looks huge.
The home looks, it's big.
It would be.
Yeah, it would be good for a family.
I think it's a good size without being just gratuitously large for like a family of four.
Yeah, she's She's a cutie.
Been around a little while. Almost 20 years. 20 yeah. years this year. So.
Yeah. It's been a fun ride. So, well, guys, if you have any real quick last questions, or if you want to put any questions in the comments below, if you get here late and I didn't question all your answers, then please let me know.
Anybody ask anything about any colors or anything earlier?
Is Molly still art too? Huh? Do you still art?
Sometimes.
Yes, she does do art, and I'm pushing her to. She's amazing. More better than I am.
Aww.
Yes, she is.
Thank you.
So, yeah, the colors, we tried to just, it's four bedrooms. We tried to just do something neutral, sort of the whole blank slate kind of deal. So what product did you use to glaze your bathtub? It is specifically designed, I don't remember the name of it. It's at your big box home improvement stores. It is a enamel that's designed specifically for that, and you have to do very specific careful things to the inside, about 15 steps in order to make it actually stick. So, and then it was two coats at specific interval, or three coats, yeah, at specific intervals. And how many bedrooms? Four, so four beds, two full baths. So okay, guys, good to be here, and thank you guys so much. This has been a pretty cool thing. Just having an interaction with everybody and getting to know some of you, you know, as little as you can get to know somebody just on the interwebs. But
yeah,
it's been fun. So Aaron, thank you. All right, God bless, love you guys, and we'll see you next time.
Bye.